your world. Love.
Visitation, nothing else will do. We want more and more and more and more of you. You have given us so much more than we deserve, and you deliver us by the power of your word. So God, we lift you up, giving you the honor that is yours. Thank you for your love, Father, this is what we're living for. Holy Spirit, fill us with your fire, your desires, hold us close to you. Holy Spirit, give us revelation, healing visitation, nothing else will do. We want more and more and more and more.
I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I know it was a long one, but I just wanted to share this with you. It's a little scripture. I am not ashamed of the gospel, for it is the power of God for salvation to everyone who believes. I just wanted to say that by you watching these videos, I hope you guys can see that Jesus loves you, and that I personally am not ashamed of the gospel, and that through these videos I hope I am sharing with you who Christ is. What About is where I will answer some very hard, tough questions that most Christians shy away from answering.
Understand you're a pastor, okay? I'm sorry, but I hate pastors. They're frauds. Listen, I don't care what your Bible says. I'll do what I want to do. Yeah, you can do what you want to do. You can be the way you want to be, but if it all leads to certain death, what's the point? I've been there. Don't you understand? I've been where you're at. I know what you're going through. And it's nothing but emptiness and darkness and no joy, no happiness. It's filthy and disgusting because you always feel guilty and ashamed for what you do. But because of Christ, I know I'm forgiven. I forgive myself. And that guilt and that shame is coming up once in a while, but it's washed away. I know because Christ has forgiven me and he has forgotten it. The consequences are still there, but he has forgotten it.
That's where I'm stopping you. Okay? Now listen to me. I am sick and tired of these games that you always play. Oh, I'm gonna witness to this kid. Oh, I'm gonna win his soul.
And the nation and the million faces formed together, made for elevation. And the soldier won't surrender. Faith is like a fire that never burns to embers. The voice of the unheard. Love is the end.
Tulsa. Darkness, emptiness, and void. We all know this feeling. We have all been there and felt that before. Like being in space with no sound, all alone in the darkness.
Hey guys, hope you're all doing well. I just wanted to create this video, and I wanted to read you guys something. It's going to be a couple minutes, maybe. But I want to read you from the Bible, and I want to read from Romans 1, verse 16, to chapter 2, verse 24. Yes, that is long. Again, I said it's Romans 1, 16, to Romans 2, 24. So here we go. For I am not ashamed of this good news about Christ. It is the power of God at work, saving everyone who believes, the Jew first and also the Gentile. This good news tells us how God makes us right in his sight. So to get right to the point today, I've got a game I'd like you all to play. It's called How many teenagers do you know that are actively pursuing a life with God? For most of us, that game doesn't last very long.
Hey guys, how you guys doing? Good. All right, that's straight. There we go. That's straight. All right, sorry. I just wanted to create this video. As I told you guys before, I am here to tell you about who I am.
Hey guys. So this is gonna be one of the first videos I have created while driving. So I know that sometimes it's not easy.
But sorry about that. As you can tell, I am driving, so I can't pick you up yet.
So.
Hey guys, major update here. Okay, I need your help because I want to create this video that's going to be hilarious. Now, I need your help though, all right, because I really need your help. So here's what I need your help with. I need you guys to write in the comments section of this video a tongue twister sentence that you would like me to try to attempt to say, because this is going to be awesome.
Hey everybody, I just wanted to read to you the book that I am writing, which is called Chosen One. And now this book is not published. It is just a book that I wanted to write. Chapter 1, Love God and Love People. Chapter 2, Jesus Cried. Chapter 3, Pool Pass. Chapter 4, In a Pickle. Chapter 5, The World and Believers. Chapter 6, Don't Worship False Gods. Chapter 7, At the Mercy of a King.
Chapter 8, Love versus Lust.
God! Hey everybody, hope you're all doing good.
My name is Brandon Vitron. I am in 10th grade. My church is called Grace Assembly of God. We've been around for 10 years. Right now we are in an art gallery. It's called the Banana Factory. It's in Bethlehem. We arrive here at 8:55 every Sunday. The very first thing that we have to do is we have to set up a sign. It's on top of our car, strapped down, so we have to take it off the car and we have to cross a two-lane highway. We come to an empty room, so we have to set up every single Sunday. I am responsible for bringing the equipment in and making sure that the sound equipment is all hooked up. I started leading worship when I was 11 years old, and ever since then I led worship every Sunday. So one of the things of being a pastor's kid in a small church is that there is a lot of sacrifices. Church doesn't happen just on Sundays. It happens pretty much every day of the week for me, but it's all worth it in the end. When I was little, I used to wake up very early because my parents said I had to wake up and that we had to go to church. Now that I'm older and I can understand it, I wake up because I want to wake up, and I go to church because I want to go to church. I do it because I want to see people come to Christ. I really want to see people's lives transformed. I want to see my life personally be transformed every day. The joy in all the sacrifices is knowing that one day it is going to pay off. So every minute I put into the ministry, all the work that I do, I know it's all worth it because people are coming to Christ, their lives are being transformed, and that's all worth it for me. I have never been to youth camp before. I have seen videos about it, and I saw that it was a lot of fun. I saw that a lot of people worshiped the Lord there, and I think it was really awesome.
I want you to meet Brandon. Would you put your hands together and let's welcome Brandon, a student in ministry. How you doing?
Deny. You're the fire that makes me come alive. It's a love that I can't hide. It's burning deep inside wherever I go. Wherever I go. I've got that good feeling. Kicking me out of my chair. Dancing like I don't care. I've got that good feeling. Shouting it out cause I can't contain it.
Dear God, I've got this urge, this feeling.
Hello, everybody. Right here I am in front of the sign that says the University of Valley Village. I'm here at Breakaway. This is my friend, Josh Bowerman.
Hello. Hello, people.
So yeah, here, right, yeah. I like
it. I love it. It's a pretty good fit. So far, reached and surpassed all my expectations. A good Christian community and solid classes. The small classes let you have a good personal relationship with your professor.
Yeah. So you're a freshman, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's awesome. What's your name?
Life is gonna shake me. You
said, this world is gonna bring trouble on my soul. This I know, whenever